Welcome back to All Indiana. Well, it's called Vinyl. It's a new dating app that helps you find your perfect match based on the music you like. Now, I caught up with the creator, Rachel Van Norwick, to find out just how it works and tips to finding love during a pandemic.
I want to dive right into your incredible app. So tell us about this app you created.
Sure. So I created an app called Vinyl.ly, and Vinyl.ly is a dating app that's based entirely on music compatibility. So we take your Spotify listening history and combine it with a few questions to sort of round out your music taste. And then that's how we create matches.
That is so cool. And what gave you this idea? Is that kind of the first thing that people talk about when they go on a first date or get to know each other, like their taste of music?
Music is a big deal, you know, for some people, it can be their entire identity. For other people, you know, you just want to know you have sort of that plus one, you know, to go to a concert or to, you know, share in or discover new music. So, you know, the way that I sort of found Vinyl.ly was basically that I saw my friends and family struggling on the traditional dating apps and just sort of, perpetually swiping. And these same people were huge music fans like I was. And so I saw the opportunity to create an app that just, you know, really dove into someone's music DNA and made matches that way.
Now, have you had some success stories from the music matches?
Yeah, we've definitely had, some great matches made and great chats. And we have, you know, the opportunity within the app that you can invite people to see a live stream concert. We do have also the ability to invite someone to a live concert when they return. And so it's really great because it sort of makes for a natural, date opportunity for people. And you can, you know, you can press on someone's playlist and play all the songs they've been listening to. And those are great conversation starters.
Yeah, it's very telling about someone. What do you tell someone that's a little apprehensive about going on a dating app? I personally have not ever been on a dating app, but I love, I'm going to admit this, to go with my friends and like swipe for them.
Right.
But what would you tell someone that's a little scared, but they want to find a connection with someone?
Yeah, I mean, and I totally understand it is scary. It can feel impersonal. You know, you sort of wonder if the people that you're meeting, you know, if they're sort of being truthful about who they are and you know, all of that. With Vinyl.ly, you know, I guess the great thing is that, you know, it's free to use. B, it's a really quick process. I mean, it syncs right away with your Spotify listening history. So it's not this long process or a lot of questions. And, you know, it's really all about the music. So, I mean, the goal was to have a data-driven app that, you know, was not based on sort of superficial characteristics. So I think for people who may be kind of apprehensive or actually maybe just burn out from other dating apps, it's a really nice opportunity, especially if, you know, music is important to you.
Now, during this pandemic, obviously it is hard to meet people face to face. So what are a few tips you have to kind of keep things interesting if you are connecting with someone to kind of keep that momentum going?
Yeah, I agree. You know, it is sort of difficult, right, when everything's done virtually. Mm-hmm. So I think, you know, if you can, watch a movie together, let's say, you know, okay, and sort of have chat lines open for something like that, where you would, you know, sort of be doing something you would on a date with someone naturally, or, you know, go for, you know, a socially distanced bike ride.
That's cool.
You can be, you know, if you want to be together, but, you know, want to, you know, still maintain that, you know, 6 feet distance, a bike ride is great. And then obviously, you know, from a music perspective, I would say, you know, bring along like a Bluetooth speaker and take turns sort of playing songs along your ride and get to know each other.
I love it. Now we're here in the Midwest, it's freezing, but I was like, ooh, a virtual bike ride too. You could take each other on and see, I can kind of do that.
Yeah,
as well.
Just bundle up.
Yes,
you know,
that's really cool. Okay. Has there ever been like a no-go? Maybe someone's like a Nine Inch Nails fan and someone's over here in like Kenny G land. Have you seen some real people that are not compatible?
You know, I would say even with that example that, you know, there are shared influences there. So,
true.
Nine Inch Nails, like Trent Reznor is like, you know, definitely like delved into classic music and classical music. And so, you know, Kenny G as well, like the instrumentation. So it's surprising. You actually, you know, that's what's great about Vinyl.ly is that you can actually find more commonalities than not.
Wow.
Yes. And it's not based sort of on one-to-one. So it's not like if you liked, you know, a certain artist and I didn't, that we wouldn't match. It's really about, you know, sort of what shaped the artist, what also has shaped your sort of music preferences. And we use all of those things to make matches.
I thought this was such a cool concept. Again, find Vinyly at vinylyapp.com.